Our planet's geography is filled with peculiarities and curiosities, whose existence is a bit counterintuitive on first glance. One example of this are the thin strips of land which make their way into the oceans and seas, seemingly unbothered by the relentless winds and currents acting upon them. These landforms are called spits, and they can actually be found all over the world. While they may resemble breakwaters, which are built by humans to protect coastal structures from wind and currents, these spits are actually created through an intricate balance of geological and hydrological processes, without any human intervention. In this video, we learn all about these processes, taking the Curonian Spit, which stretches between Lithuania and Russia in the Baltic Sea, as a case study. Let's say you're appointed as Mother Nature for a day, and you want to surprise the inhabitants of planet Earth with a new spit. There are a few key ingredients you need to accomplish this, consisting of winds and currents, a river, and a stretch of uniquely shaped land. Starting off with the land and water, what you're looking for is a coastline with different types of rock running perpendicular to the shore, which is called a discordant coastline. When the different rocks have vastly different hardnesses, one type tends to erode faster than the other, creating a wave pattern on the coastline with sections called bays and headlands. These are your foundation for the spit and act as the anchor for the material of your future spit to accumulate. The next ingredient you need is wind, which is the engine of spit building. Not every wind does the job, however. What you need is a predominant wind direction, which hits your shore at an oblique angle, preferably around 45 degrees, to get the maximum movement out of it. The wind now creates waves near your shoreline, which break on your beach in a repetitive angle. Every time the wave hits, it carries with it the sand and sediments from the seafloor and moves it in an angle up the shore. After the wave breaks, the so-called backwash, with the help of gravity, moves the material back in a perpendicular line, leaving it to be picked up by the next wave. This process is called longshore drift, and if it happens long enough, vast amounts of material can be transported along a beach. Taking a look at our shoreline from earlier, the shape of the headland now comes into play. When the material of the longshore drift approaches a headland, which bends away in an angle above approximately 30 degrees, the waves don't break anymore since there's no land, and instead they dissipate, depositing the material on the seafloor and slowly building up layers until it reaches the surface and creates new land. The newly formed land at the entrance of a bay would now become an easy target for the currents to be just washed away again. But this is where the river comes into play. The discharge of the river in the bay creates a counteracting pressure, which keeps the deposited material where it was placed by the drift, and sometimes even helps construct the spit from the other side with its own sediments. The way these forces interact with each other, the pressure from the river discharge and the longshore drift, determine the shape and course of a spit. This means that as a spit grows, if the forces fall out of balance, for example when the spit grows too far away from the supporting river, the growth is halted and the eroding forces get to work, potentially destroying the spit again. Now that we have all the ingredients needed to make a spit, let's look at a real-world example to see how these forces have played out over time. The Curonian Spit on the shore of the Kaliningrad Oblast in Russia and Lithuania is one of the longest spits in the world, spanning 98 kilometers or 61 miles around the Curonian Lagoon. Large cliffs to the west of the Baltic have supplied vast amounts of sediments to the area, and the predominant western winds have created longshore drift, which carries these sediments along the shore. The sharp dip at the entrance of the bay has caused the deposition of the sediments for many thousands of years, slowly building up new land. Several rivers like the Reka Dema, Reka Zhevka and Reka Matruzova in Russia and the Skirvite and Drevena in Lithuania are pushing back against the current, making the spit grow longer and longer until it touches the land on the other side of the bay. Several hooks have been created along the landform due to momentary changes in wind direction and the pressure from rivers, leading to vastly different thicknesses along the spit, ranging from a few hundred meters to up to 4 kilometers. Over the centuries, vegetation has grown on the spit, strengthening its structure, and winds have towered up enormous dunes along the way, but in many places the spit is just a few meters in height. This fragility means that spits are dependent on the balance of forces acting upon it. The slightest change in boundary conditions can quickly mean its demise again. The boundary conditions can either be a change of the wind direction, but human interference can also be detrimental. Humans have the tendency to play Mother Nature when it comes to the course of rivers, with dams and canals blocking the flow or changing its course. Another means of people messing with nature's creation is the construction of rock groins along beaches, which prevent the sediment transport through longshore drift, tipping the mass balance so that the spits slowly but surely deteriorate. Deforestation of the Curonian Spit, which weakens its base structure, canals and dams along the river supporting it, and the blocking of sediments along the Baltic shore, have actually changed the mass balance of the spit to such an extent that the spit would disappear without human intervention. To ensure the longevity of the fragile ecosystems, many spits have been put under protection. The Curonian Spit, for example, is a UNESCO World Heritage Site due to its unique size and general spatial structure, demonstrating the harmonious coexistence between humans and nature, according to UNESCO. But an active effort is needed to make sure that this idyllic landscape can be enjoyed for generations to come. The region of the Curonian Spit is also a hotspot for amber, a fossilized tree resin which gets washed up on the Baltic beaches. To learn more about where these amber stones come from and what the best way is to find them, you can watch this video next, or choose the one which YouTube thinks you might enjoy here. Thanks for watching, subscribe and leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Cheers.